So I have some bad news. When I started Submerged, I went in with the mindset that this was a well-executed indie game I hoped to recommend for people that have not heard about it. Like, I play games in the hopes of having fun, whether I think it's for me or not. This happened to be a title I felt would appeal to me, and although I went in with that thought process, unfortunately, I can't recommend it. At the beginning, everything feels great. The world design is lovely, the music is automatically engaging, and the story, told completely through images, looks promising. For the most part, these aesthetic properties continue being good throughout the game. The problem is the actual game, or lack thereof. Yes, I knew on the outset that this is a combat-free game focused on exploration. I signed up for that. But for some reason, I got the impression that Submerged was going to take an approach like Prince of Persia, platforming your way through a waterlogged world. I was excited to jump and run from building to building, finding hidden discoveries in tucked away places of the map. Well, that's not what happens. You play Miku, a young girl who needs to help her wounded brother Taku by collecting supplies from this flooded city. Gameplay consists of getting in a boat, going up to a building, getting off the boat, and then pressing the direction you want to go until you reach the top of said building. You auto-jump, or climb where possible, hardly giving the game any more input than the direction you prefer to move. And usually, there are few options in that regard. One of the biggest decisions I had to make was climbing a ledge or climbing a drainpipe. I later realized this was also a false choice because you couldn't traverse the broken ledge. It was there to get you down when you were done climbing up the building. It's basically a walking simulator, but with more vertical movement. It's a climbing simulator. There is also a lot of backtracking. Climb across a vine wall, grab a collectible picture, climb back across the vine wall. It's just very boring. And this is really sad because the quality of the graphics and sound design is easily seen from the start. There seems to be a very personal story being told as well, and if the game feels monotonous, that all falls away. And even then, the game is very short by modern standards, basically the length of one of those walking simulators I mentioned before, unless you'd like to collect all the little pictures. And there are quite a few little pictures. Maybe it would be longer then, if you don't fall asleep trying. You can also discover the local animals, all 8 of them, or special locations, all 8 of them, which you find by floating around in your boat. Also, you find a series of overturned boats which will give your boat boost power. You might think, oh, if my boat has a boost, there must be some places that can only be accessed by boosting. And you would be wrong. It only makes it slightly faster to move across the map. I feel like there are two kinds of people that will pick up this game. The first kind is one that is not aware of what the game is and feels deflated when they find out. That would be me. The other kind is one that is fully aware of what the game is and feels deflated that it is so short. Both camps should know that going in. The game does tout itself as a serene and relaxing game, and yes, you will probably get that from playing, but the story also suggests that your brother is in peril and desperately needs every supply you collect. The narrative sets up a sense of urgency and then states, "Go at your own pace." This is so hard. The art direction, the musical score, the sound design, the story structure, the world building, it all feels so well done, but there's just no gameplay to hold your attention. And I mean, I'm the person who played Dear Esther and Gone Home. I suppose in those cases I understood what they were, and they kept dropping story elements the entire time to keep expanding the narrative over a couple hours. Submerged drops a cutscene after you collect each supply and then has a long period of just climbing up a building. It's kind of like the part in Shadow of the Colossus where you have to climb up the monsters, but without the monsters. Therefore, I give Submerged 3 out of 16 colossi. Because the game kind of has like 3 colossi. There's two whales and a whale shark. I mean, there are other animals in the game, but those are like pretty colossal. So that would be the 3 out of... You get it. It's a long hike up to the top of this crane. But at least I got my exercise in, that's something. This is, by the way, the fastest that I can actually go on foot. Kind of wish I had an option to go faster, but that's only in the boat. Yep, just gonna keep on climbing on up. Gonna be a great vantage point when I get to the top. Yep, pretty great view. Now what? Whee! Ooh, yeah! Slide down the endless ladder of fun! This is the most fun I've had in the game so far. That's kind of sad, really, but I'll take it.